Matthew 3:6. Please do it, for I must do all that is right. No, for the scriptures tell us that bread won't feed men's souls. Obedience to every word of God is what we need. It also says not to put the Lord your God to a foolish test. Get out of here, Satan. The scriptures say, worship only the Lord your God and obey only him. Turn from sin and turn to God, for the kingdom of heaven is near. Come along with me, and I will show you how to fish for the souls of men. Humble men are very fortunate, for the kingdom of heaven is given to them. Those who mourn are fortunate, for they shall be comforted. The meek and lowly are fortunate, for the whole world belongs to them. Happy are those who long to be just and good, for they shall be completely satisfied. Happy are the kind and merciful, for they shall be shown mercy. Happy are those whose hearts are pure, for they shall see the kingdom of God. Happy are those who strive for peace, they shall be called the sons of God. Happy are those who are persecuted because they are good, for the kingdom of heaven is theirs. When you are reviled and prosecuted and lied about because you are my followers, wonderful, be happy about it, be glad. For a tremendous reward awaits you in heaven, and remember the ancient prophets were prosecuted too. You are the world's seasoning, to make it tolerable. If you lose your flavor, what will happen to the world? And you yourselves will be thrown out and trampled underfoot as worthless. You are the world's light, a city on a hill, glowing in the night, for all to see. Don't hide your light. Let it shine for all. Let your good deeds glow for all to see, so that they praise your heavenly Father. Don't misunderstand why I have come. It is not to cancel the laws of Moses and the warnings of the prophets. No, I came to fulfill them and to make them all come true. With all the earnestness I have, I say, every law in the book will continue until its purpose is achieved. And so if anyone breaks the least commandment and teaches others to, he shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. But those who teach God's laws and obey them shall be great in the kingdom of heaven. But I warn you, unless your goodness is greater than that of the Pharisees and other Jewish leaders, you can't get into the kingdom of heaven at all. Under the laws of Moses, the rule was, if you murder, you must die. But I have added to that rule, and I tell you that if you are only angry, even in your own home, you are in danger of judgment. If you call your friend an idiot, you are in danger of being brought before the court. And if you curse him, you are in danger of the fires of hell. So if you are standing before the altar in the temple, offering a sacrifice to God, and suddenly remember that a friend has something against you, leave your sacrifice there besides the altar, and go and apologize and be reconciled to him, and then come and offer your sacrifice to God. Come to terms quickly with your enemy before it is too late, and he drags you into court, and you are thrown into a debater's cell, for you will stay there until you have paid every last penny. The laws of Moses said, you shall not commit adultery. But I say, anyone who even looks at a woman with lust in his eye has already committed adultery with her in his heart. So if your eye, even if it's your best eye, causes you to lust, gouge it out, throw it away. Better for part of you to be destroyed than for all of you to be cast into hell. And if your hand, even your right hand, causes you to sin, cut it off and throw it away. Better that then find yourself in hell. The law of Moses says if anyone wants to be rid of his wife, he can divorce her merely by giving her a letter of dismissal. But I say that a man who divorces his wife except for fornication causes her to commit adultery if she marries again, and he who marries her commits adultery. Again, the law of Moses says you shall not break your vows to God, but must fulfill them all. But I say, don't make any vows, and even to say by heavens is a sacred vow to God, for the heavens are God's throne. And if you say by the earth, It is sacred vow, for the earth is his footstool. And don't swear by Jerusalem, for Jerusalem is the capital of the great king. Don't even swear by my head, for you can't turn one hair white or black. Say just a simple yes I will or no I won't. Your word is enough. To strengthen your promise with a vow shows that something is wrong. The law of Moses says if a man gouges out another's eye, he must pay with his own eye. If a tooth gets knocked out, knock out the tooth of the one who did it. But I say, don't resist violence. If you are slapped on one cheek, turn the other too. If you are ordered to court and your shirt is taken from you, give your coat too. If the military demands that you carry their gear for a mile, carry it too. Give those to who ask, and don't turn away those who want to borrow. There is a saying, love your friends and hate your enemies, but I say, love your enemies. Pray for those who persecute you. In that way, you will be acting as true sons of the Father in heaven, for he gives his sunlight to both the evil and the good, and sends rain on the just and on the unjust too. If you love only those who love you, what good is that? Even scoundrels do that much. If you are friendly only to your friends, how are you different from anyone else? Even the heathen do that. But you are to be perfect, even as your Father in heaven is perfect. Take care. Don't do your good deeds publicly to be admired, for then you will lose the reward from your Father in heaven. When you give a gift to a beggar, don't shout about it as the hypocrites do, blowing trumpets in the synagogues and streets to call attention to their acts of charity. I tell you in all earnestness, they have received all the reward they will get. But when you do kind things for someone, do it in secret. Don't tell your left hand what your right hand is doing, and your Father, who knows all secrets, will reward you. And now about prayer. When you pray, don't be like the hypocrites, who seek attention by praying publicly on the street corners and in the synagogues where everyone can see them. Truly, that is all the reward they will ever get. But when you pray, go away by yourself all alone and shut the door behind you, and pray to your Father secretly, and your Father who knows your secrets will reward you. Don't recite the same prayer over and over as the heathen do, who think prayers are answered only by repeating them again and again. Remember, your Father knows exactly what you need even before you ask him. Pray along these lines. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Your heavenly Father will forgive you if you forgive those who sin against you. But if you refuse to forgive them, he will not forgive you. And now, about fasting. When you fast, declining your food for spiritual purpose, don't do it publicly as the hypocrites do, who try to look very hungry around people so they'll feel sorry for them. Truly, that is the only reward they will ever get. But when you fast, put on fancy clothing and be well-groomed and look happy and healthy, so that no one will suspect that you're going hungry, except your Father who knows every secret, and he will reward you. That is how you fast. Don't store up treasures here on earth where they can erode away or be stolen. Store them in heaven where they will never lose their value and are safe from thieves. If your profits are in heaven, your heart will be there too. If your eye is pure, there will be sunshine in your soul. But if your eye is clouded with evil thoughts and desires, you are in a deep spiritual darkness, and oh, how deep that darkness can be. You cannot serve two masters, God and money, for you will hate one and love the other, or else the other way around. So my counsel is, don't worry about things, food, drink, and clothes, for you already have life and a body, and they are far more important than what to eat and wear. Look at the birds. They don't worry about what to eat. They don't need to sow or reap or store up food, for your heavenly Father feeds them. and you are far more valuable to Him than they are. Will all your worries add a single moment to your life? And why worry about your clothes? Look at the flowers in the field. They don't worry about theirs. Yet King Solomon in all his glory was not clothed as beautifully as they. And if God cares so wonderfully for flowers that are here today and gone tomorrow, won't He more surely care for you, O men of little faith? No longer worry about having enough food or clothing. Why be like the heathen? For they take pride in all these things and are deeply concerned about them. But your heavenly Father already knows perfectly well that you need them, and He will give them to you if you give Him first place in your life and live as He wants you to. So don't be anxious about tomorrow. God will take care of your tomorrow too. Live one day at a time. Matthew 7 through 9. Judge not, that you be not judged. For with the judgment you judge, you will be judged. And with the measure you use it, it will be measured back to you. And why do you look at the speck in your brother's eye, but do not consider the plank in your own eye? How can you say to your brother, "Let me remove the speck from your eye," and look, a plank is in your eye? Hypocrite! First remove the plank from your own eye, and then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye. Do not give what is holy to the dogs, nor cast your pearls before swine, lest they trample them under their feet and turn and tear you into pieces. Ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks it will be opened. Or what man is there among you who, if his son asks for bread, will give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will he give him a serpent? If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father who is in heaven give good things to those who ask Him? Therefore, whatever you want men to do to you, do also to them. For this is the law and the prophets. Enter by the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leads to destruction, and there are many who go in by it. Because narrow is the gate and difficult is the way which leads to life, and there is only a few who find it. Beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravenous wolves. You will know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes from thorns bushes or figs from thistles? Even so, every good tree bears good fruit, but a bad tree bears bad fruit. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, nor can a bad tree bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. Therefore, by their fruits you will know them. Not everyone who says to me, "Lord, Lord," shall enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father in heaven. Many will say to me on that day, "Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in your name, cast out demons in your name, and done many wonders in your name?" And then I will declare to them, "I never knew you. Depart from me, you who practice lawlessness." Therefore, whoever hears these sayings of mine and does them, I will liken him to a wise man who built his house on a rock. And the rain descended, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house, and it did not fall, for it was founded on the rock. But anyone who hears these sayings of mine and does not do them will be like a foolish man who built his house on the sand. And the rain descended, the floods came, and the wind blew and beat on that house, and it fell, and it was a great fall. I am willing. Be cleansed. See that you tell no one, but go your way. Show yourself to the priest and offer the gift that Moses commanded as a testimony to them. Assuredly, I say to you, I have not found such great faith, not even in Israel. And I say to you that many will come from east and west and sit down with Abraham, Isaac, Jacob in the kingdom of heaven. But the sons of the kingdom will be cast out into outer darkness. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Go your way, and as you have believed, so let it be done for you. Foxes have holes to sleep in, and birds of the air have nests. But the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Follow me, and let the dead bury their own dead. Why are you fearful, O you of little faith? Go, sons, be of good cheer. Your sins are forgiven you. Why do you think evil in your hearts? For which is easier to say, your sins are forgiven you, or say, arise and walk? But that you may know that the Son of Man has power on earth to forgive sins, arise, take up your bed, and go to your house. Follow me. Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. But go and learn what that means. I desire mercy and not sacrifice, for I did not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. Can the friends of the bridegroom mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? But the days will come when the bridegroom will be taken away from them, and then they will fast. No one puts a piece of unshrunk cloth on an old garment, for the patch pulls away from the garment, and the tear is made worse. Nor do they put wine into old wineskins, or else the wineskins break. The wine is spilled, and the wineskins are ruined. But they put new wine into new wineskins, and both are preserved. Be of good cheer, daughter. Your faith has made you well. Make room, for the girl is not dead, but sleeping. Do you believe that I am able to do this? According to your faith, let it be to you. See that no one knows it. The harvest truly is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray to the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into the harvest. Matthew 10. Do not go into the way of the Gentiles, and do not enter a city of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. And as you go, preach, saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out demons. Freely you have received, freely give. Provide neither gold nor silver nor copper in your money belts, nor bag for your journey, nor two tunics, nor sandals, nor staffs, for a worker is worthy of his food. Now whatever city or town you enter, inquire who in it is worthy, and stay there till you go out. And when you go into a household, greet it. If the household is worthy, let your peace come upon it. But if it's not worthy, let your peace return to you. And whoever will not receive you, nor hear your words, when you depart from that house or city, shake off the dust from your feet. Assuredly, I say to you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than for that city. Behold, I send you out as sheep in the midst of wolves. Therefore, be wise as serpents and harmless as doves. But beware of men, for they will deliver you up to the councils and scourge you in their synagogues. You will be brought before governors and kings for my sake, as a testimony to them and to the Gentiles. But when they deliver you up, do not worry about how or what you should speak, for it will be given to you in that hour what you should speak. For it is not who you speak, but the Spirit of your Father who speaks in you. Now brother will deliver a brother to death, and a father his child. And children will rise up against parents and cause them to be put to death. And you will be hated by all my name's sake. But he who endures till the end will be saved. When they persecute you in the city, flee to another. For as surely I say to you, you will not have gone through the cities of Israel before the Son of Man comes. A disciple is not above his teacher, nor a servant above his master. It is enough for a disciple that he be like his teacher, and a servant like his master. If they have called the master of the house devil, how much more will they call those of his household? Therefore, do not fear them, for there is nothing covered that will not be revealed, and hidden that will not be known. Whatever I tell you in the dark, speak in the light. And what you hear in the ear, preach on the rooftops. And do not fear those who can kill the body but cannot kill the soul, but rather fear him who is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. And not two sparrows sold for a copper coin? And not one of them falls to the ground apart from your Father's will. But the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Do not fear, therefore. You are more valuable than many sparrows. Therefore, whoever confesses me before men, him I will also confess before my Father who is in heaven. But whoever denies me before men, him I will also deny before my Father who is in heaven. He who loves father and mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he who loves his daughter or son more than me is not worthy of me. And he who does not take up his cross and follow me is not worthy of me. He who finds his life will lose it, and he who loses his life for my sake will find it. He who receives you receives me, and he who receives me receives him who sent me. He who receives a prophet in the name of a prophet shall receive a prophet's reward. And he who receives a righteous man in the name of a righteous man shall receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives one of these little ones only a cup of cold water in the name of a disciple, assuredly, I say to you, he shall by no means lose his reward. Matthew 11. Go and tell John the things which you hear and see. The blind see, and the lame walk. The lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear. The dead are raised up, and the poor have the gospel preached to them. And blessed is he who is not offended because of me. What did you go out in the wilderness to see? A reed shaken by the wind? But what did you go out to see? A man clothed in soft garments? Indeed, those who wear soft clothing are in kings' houses. But what did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I say to you, and more than a prophet, for this is he of whom it is written, Behold, I send my messenger before your face, who will prepare your way before you. Assuredly, I say to you, among those born of women, there are not risen one greater than John the Baptist, but he who is the least of the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, and the violent take it by force. For all the prophets and the law prophesied until John. And if you are willing to receive it, he is Elijah who is to come. He who has ears to hear, let him hear. But to what shall I liken this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to their companions and saying, We played the flute for you, and you did not dance. We mourned to you, and you did not lament. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, He has a demon. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, Look, a glutton and a wine bibber, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. But wisdom is justified by her children. Woe to you, Chorazin! Woe to you, Bethsaida! For if the mighty works which were done in you had been done in Tyre and Sidon, they would have repented long ago in sackcloth and ashes. But I say to you, it will be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon in the day of judgment than for you. And you, Capernaum, who are exalted to heaven, will be brought down to Hades. For if the mighty works which were done in you had been done in Sodom, it would have remained until this day. But I say to you that it shall be more tolerable for the land of Sodom in the day of judgment than for you. I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that you have hidden these things from the wise and prudent, and have revealed them to the babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in your sight. All things have been delivered to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, nor does anyone know the Father except the Son, and the one to whom the Son wills to reveal him. Come to me, all you who are labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Matthew 12. Have you not read what David did when he was hungry? He and those who were with him. How he entered the house of God and ate the showbread, which was not lawful for him to eat, nor for those who were with him, but only for the priests? Or have you not read in the law that on Sabbath the priests in the temple profane the Sabbath and are blameless? Yet I say to you that in this place there is one greater than the temple. But if you had known what this means, I desire mercy and not sacrifice, you would not have condemned the guiltless. For the Son of Man is Lord even of the Sabbath. What man is there among you who has one sheep, and if it falls into a pit on the Sabbath, will not lay hold of it and lift it out? Of how much more valuable then is that man than a sheep? Therefore, it is lawful to do good on the Sabbath. Stretch out your hand. Every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation, and every city or house divided against itself will not stand. If Satan cast out Satan, he is divided against himself. How then will his kingdom stand? And if I cast out demons with the power of the devil, by whom do your sons cast them out? Therefore, they shall be your judges. But if I cast out demons by the Spirit of God, surely the kingdom has come upon you. Or how can one enter a strong man's house and plunder his goods, unless he first binds the strong man, and then he will plunder his house? He who is not with me is against me, and he who does not gather with me scatters abroad. Therefore I say to you, every sin and blasphemy will be forgiven men, but the blasphemy against the Holy Spirit will not be forgiven men. Anyone who speaks a word against the Son of Man, it will be forgiven him. But whoever speaks against the Holy Spirit, it will not be forgiven him, either in this age or in the age to come. Either make the tree good and its fruit good, or else make the tree bad and its fruit bad. For a tree is known by its fruit. Brood of vipers, so how can you, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. A good man, out of the good treasure of his heart, brings forth good things. And an evil man, out of the evil treasure, brings forth evil things. But I say to you, that for every idle word men may speak, they will give account on the day of judgment. For by words you will be justified, and by your words you will be condemned. An evil and adulterous generation seeks after a sign, and no sign will be given to it except the sign of a prophet Jonah. For as Jonah was 3 days and 3 nights in the belly of the great fish, so will the Son of Man be in 3 days and 3 nights in the heart of the earth. The men of Nineveh will rise up in the judgment with this generation and condemn it, because they repented at the preaching of Jonah. And indeed, a greater than Jonah is here. The queen of the south will rise up in the judgment with this generation and condemn it. For she came from the ends of the earth to hear the wisdom of Solomon, and indeed, a greater than Solomon is here. When an unclean spirit goes out of a man, he goes through dry places, seeking rest, and finds none. Then he says, I will return to my house from which I came. And when he comes, he finds it empty, swept, and put in order. Then he goes and takes with him 7 other spirits more wicked than himself, and they enter and dwell there. And the last state of that man is worse than the first. So shall it also be with this wicked generation? Who is my mother, and who is my brothers? Here are my mother and my brothers, for whoever does the will of my Father in heaven is my brother and sister and mother. Matthew 13. Behold, a sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seed fell by the wayside, and the birds came and devoured them. Some fell on stony places, where they did not have much earth, and they immediately sprang up, because they had no depth of earth. But when the sun was up, they were scorched, and because they had no root, they withered away. And some fell among thorns, and the thorns sprang up and choked them. But others fell on the ground and yielded a crop, some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. He who has ears to hear, let him hear. Because it has been given to you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it has not been given. For whoever has, to him more will be given, and he will have abundance. But whoever does not have, even what he has will be taken away from him. Therefore I speak to them in parables, because seeing they do not see, and hearing they do not hear, nor do they understand. And in them the prophecy of Isaiah is fulfilled, which says, hearing you will hear and shall not understand, and seeing you will see and not perceive. For the hearts of his people have grown dull, their ears are hard of hearing, and their eyes they have closed, lest they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears, lest should they understand with their hearts and turn, so that I should heal them. But blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears they hear. For assuredly I say to you, that many prophets and righteous men desired to see what you see, and did not see it, and to hear what you hear, and did not hear it. Therefore, hear the parable of the sower. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, then the wicked one comes and snatches away what was sown in his heart. This is he who receives seed by the wayside. But he who receives the seed on stony places, this is he who hears the word and immediately receives it with joy. Yet he has not root in himself, but endures only for a while. For then tribulation or persecution arises because of the word. Immediately he stumbles. Now he who received seed among the thorns, he is who hears the word, and the cares of this world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and he becomes unfruitful. But he who receives seed on the good ground is he who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and produces, some 100-fold, some 60, some 30. The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way. But when the grain had sprouted and produced a crop, then the tares also appeared. So the servants of the owner came and said to him, Sir, did you not sow good seed in your field? How then does it have tares? He said to them, An enemy has done this. The servants said to him, Do you want us to go and gather them up? But he said, No, lest while you gather up the tares, you also uproot the wheat with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. At the time of the harvest, I will say to the reapers, First gather together the tares and bind them in bundles to burn them, but gather the wheat into my barn. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed, which a man took and sowed in his field, which indeed is the least of all the seeds. But when it is grown, and it is greater than the herbs, and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and nest on its branches. The kingdom of heaven is like leaven, which a woman took and hid in 3 measures of meal till it was all leavened. He who sows good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world. The good seeds are the sons of the kingdom. But the tares are the sons of the wicked one. The enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the reapers are the angels. Therefore, as the tares are gathered and burned into the fire, so it will be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send out his angels, and they will gather out of his kingdom all things that offend, and those who practice lawlessness, and will cast them into the furnace of fire. There will be wailing and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine forth as the sun in the kingdom of their Father. He who has ears to hear, let him hear. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in the field, which a man found and hid. And for joy over it, he goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant seeking beautiful pearls, who when he found one pearl of great price, went and sold all that he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a dragnet that was cast down into the sea and gathered some of every kind, which when it was full, they drew to shore. And they sat down and gathered the good into vessels, but threw the bad away. So it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come forth, separate the wicked among the just, and cast them into the furnace of fire. There will be wailing and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all these things? Therefore, every scribe instructed concerning the kingdom of heaven is like a householder who brings out his treasure, things new and old. A prophet is not without honor, except in his own country and in his own house. Matthew 14 through 17. They do not need to go away. You give them something to eat. Bring them here to me. Be of good cheer. It is I. Do not be afraid. Come. O you of little faith, why did you doubt? Why do you also transgress the commandment of God? Because of your tradition? For God commanded, saying, honor your father and your mother, and he who curses father or mother, let him be put to death. But you say, whoever says his father or mother, whatever profit you might have received from me is a gift to God, then he need not to honor his father or mother. Thus you have made the commandment of God of no effect by your tradition. Hypocrites! Did Isaiah prophesy about you, saying, these people draw near to me with their mouth, and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me, and in vain they worship me, teaching as doctrines the commandments of men. Hear and understand. Not what goes into the mouth defiles a man, but what comes out of the mouth. This defiles a man. Every plant which my heavenly Father has not planted will be uprooted. Let them alone. They are blind leaders of the blind. And if the blind leads the blind, both will fall into a ditch. Are you also still without understanding? Do you not yet understand that whatever enters the mouth goes into the stomach and is eliminated? But those things which proceed out of the mouth come from the heart, and they defile a man. For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, thefts, false witness, blasphemes. These are the things which defile a man. But to eat with unwashed hands does not defile a man. I was not sent except to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the little dogs. O woman, great is your faith. Let it be to you as you desire. I have compassion on the multitude, because they have now continued with me 3 days and have nothing to eat. And I do not want to send them away hungry, lest they faint on the way. How many loaves do you have? I now will pray to our Father in heaven to multiply our food. Have a seat and sit down and eat with us, all of you. When it is evening, you say it will be fair weather, for the sky is red, and in the morning it will be foul weather. Today, for the sky is red and threatening. Hypocrites! Do you know how to discern the face of the sky? But you cannot discern the signs of the times. A wicked and adulterous generation seeks after a sign, and no sign shall be given to them except the sign of the prophet Jonah. Take heed and beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and the Sadducees. O you of little faith, why do you reason among yourselves because you have brought no bread? Do you not yet understand or remember the 5 loaves or 5,000 of how many baskets you took up, nor the 7 loaves of the 4,000 and how many large baskets you took up? How is it that you do not understand that I did not speak to you concerning bread, but to beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and the Sadducees? Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? But who do you say that I am? Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. And I also say to you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it. And I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you lose on earth will be lost in heaven. Get behind me, Satan. You are an offense to me, for you are not mindful of the things of God, but the things of men. If anyone desires to come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever desires to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. For what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for his soul? For the Son of Man will come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and he will reward each according to his works. Assuredly I say to you, there are some standing here who shall not taste death till they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. Arise, and do not be afraid. Tell the vision to no one until the Son of Man is risen from the dead. Indeed, Elijah is coming first, and will restore all things. But I say to you that Elijah has come already, and they did not know him, but did to him whatever they wished. Likewise, the Son of Man is also about to suffer at their hands. O faithless and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I bear with you? Bring him here to me. Because of your unbelief, for assuredly I say to you, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you. However, this kind does not go out except by prayer and fasting. The Son of Man is about to be betrayed into the hands of men, and they will kill him, and on the third day he will be raised up. What do you think, Simon? From whom do the kings of the earth take customs or taxes? From their sons or from strangers? Then the sons are free. Nevertheless, lest we offend them, go to the sea, cast in a hook, and take the fish that comes up first. And when you have opened its mouth, you will find a piece of money. Take that and give it to them for me and you. Matthew 18 through 19. Assuredly I say to you, unless you are converted and become as little children, you will by no means enter the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, whoever humbles himself as this little child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Whoever receives one little child like this in my name receives me. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a millstone were hung around his neck and he were drowned in the depth of the sea. Woe to the world because of offenses, for offenses must come, but woe to the man whom the offense comes. If your hand or foot causes you to sin, cut it off and cast it from you. It is better for you to enter life lame or maimed rather than having 2 hands or 2 feet to be cast into the everlasting fire. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out, cast it away from you. It is better for you to enter into life with 1 eye rather than having 2 eyes to be cast into hell. Take heed that you do not despise one of these little ones, for I say to you that in heaven their angels always see the face of my Father who is in heaven. for the Son of Man has come to save that which was lost. What do you think? If a man has 100 sheep and one of them goes astray, does he not leave the 99 and go to the mountains to seek the one that went astray? And if he should find it, assuredly I say to you, he rejoices more over that sheep than over 99 that did not go astray. Even so, it is not the will of your Father, who is in heaven, that one of these little ones should perish. Moreover, if your brother sins against you, go and tell him his faults between you and him alone. If he hears you, you have gained your brother. But if he will not hear, take with you one or two or more, that by the mouth of two or three witnesses every word may be established. And if he refuses to hear them, tell it to the church. But if he refuses to hear the church, let him be to you like a heathen and a tax collector. Assuredly, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you lose on earth will be lost in heaven. Again, I say to you that if two of you agree on earth concerning anything that they ask, it will be done for them by my Father in heaven. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, I am there in the midst of them. I do not say to you, up to 7 times, but up to 77 times. Therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like certain king who wanted to settle accounts with his servants. And when he began to settle accounts, one was brought to him who owed him 10,000 talents. But as he was not able to pay, his master commanded that he be sold, with his wife and children, and all that he had, and the payment be made. The servant therefore fell down before him, saying, Master, please have patience with me, and I will pay you all. Then the master of the servant was moved with compassion, released him, and forgave him his debt. But that same servant went out and found one of his fellow servants who owed him 100 denarii, and he laid hands on him and took him by the throat, saying, Pay me now what you owe. So his fellow servant fell down at his feet and begged him, saying, Have patience with me, I will pay you all. And he would not, but instead he went and threw him into prison till he should pay the debt. So when his fellow servants saw this and what had been done, they were grieved and came and told their master all that had been done. Then his master, after he called him, said to him, You wicked servant, I forgave you all that debt because you begged me. Should you not also have compassion on your fellow servant, just as I had pity on you? As his master was angry and delivered him into the tortures until he should pay all that was due to him, so my heavenly Father will also do to you if each of you from his heart does not forgive his brother his trespasses. Have you not read that he who made them at the beginning made them male and female, and said, For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So then they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore God has joined together, let no man separate. Moses, because of the hardness of their hearts, permitted you to divorce your wives. But from the beginning it was not so. And I say to you, whoever divorces his wife, except for sexual immorality, and marries another, commits adultery. And whoever marries her who is divorced, commits adultery. Let the little children come to me, and do not forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. Why do you call me good? No one is good, but one that is God. But if you want to enter into life, keep the commandments. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness. Honor your father and your mother. And you shall love your neighbor as yourself. If you want to be perfect, go and sell all that you have and give to the poor, and you will find treasure in heaven, and come and follow me. Assuredly, I say to you, that it is hard for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven. And again, I say to you, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. With men this is impossible, but with God all things are possible. Assuredly, I say to you, that in the regeneration, when the Son of Man sits on the throne of his glory, You who have followed me will also sit on 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And everyone who has left houses, or brothers, or sisters, or fathers, or mothers, or wives, or children, or lands, for my name's sake, shall receive 100-fold and inherit eternal life. But many who are first will be last, and the last first. Matthew 20-22. For the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out early in the morning to hire laborers for his vineyard. Now when he had agreed with the laborers for a denarius a day, he sent them into his vineyard. And he went out about the third hour and saw others standing idle in the marketplace. And he said to them, "You also go into the vineyard, and whatever is right I will give you." So they went. Again he went out about the sixth and the ninth hour and did likewise. And about the 11th hour, he went out and found others standing idle, and said to them, "Why have you been standing here idle all day?" They said to him, "Because no one hired us." He said to them, "You also go into the vineyard, and whatever is right, you will receive." So when evening had come, the owner of the vineyard said to his steward, "Call the laborers and give them their wages, beginning with the last to the first hire." And when those came who were hired, about the 11th hour, they each received a denarius. But when the first came, they supposed that they would receive more, and they likewise received each a denarius. And when they had received it, they complained against the landowner, saying, "These last men have worked only 1 hour, and you made them equal to us, who have been borne the burden and the heat all day." But he answered one of them and said, "Friend, I am doing you no wrong. Did you not agree with me for a denarius? Now take what is yours and go your way. I wish to give this last man the same as to you. It is not lawful for me to do what I wish with my own things? Or is your eye evil because I am good? So the last will be first, and the first will be last. For many are called, but few are chosen. Behold, we are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be betrayed to the chief priests and to the scribes, and they will condemn him to death and deliver him to the Gentiles to mock and to scourge and to crucify. And the third day he will rise again. What do you wish? You do not know what you ask. Are you able to drink the cup that I am about to drink and be baptized with the baptism that I am about to be baptized with? You will indeed drink my cup and be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with. But to sit on my right hand and on my left is not mine to give, but it is for those whom it is prepared for by my Father. You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them, and those who are great exercise authority over them. Yet it shall not be so among you, but whoever desires to become great among you, let him be your servant. And whoever desires to be the first among you, let him be your slave, just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many. What do you want me to do for you? Go into the village opposite you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Loose them and bring them to me. And if anyone says anything to you, you shall say, 'The Lord has need of them,' and immediately he will send them. It is written, 'My house shall be called a house of prayer,' but you have made it a den of thieves. Yes, you have read, 'Out of the mouth of babes of nursing infants, you have perfected praise.' Let no fruit grow on you ever again. Assuredly, I say to you, if you have faith and do not doubt, you will not only do what has been done to the fig tree, but also if you say to this mountain, 'Be removed and be cast into the sea,' it'll be done. And whatever things you ask in prayer, believing, you will receive. I also will ask you one thing, which if you tell me, I likewise will tell you by what authority I do these things. The baptism of John, where was it from? From heaven or from men? Neither will I tell you by what authority I do these things. But what do you think? A man had two sons, and he came to the first and said, 'Son, go, work today in my vineyard.' He answered and said, 'I will not.' But afterward, he regretted it and went. Then he came to the second and said likewise. And he answered and said, I go, sir. But he did not go. Which of the two did the will of his father? Assuredly I say to you, that tax collectors and harlots enter the kingdom of God before you. For John came to you in the way of righteousness, and you did not believe him. But tax collectors and harlots believed him. And when you saw it, you did not afterward relent and believe him. Hear another parable. There was a certain landowner who planted a vineyard and set a hedge around it, dug a winepress in it, and built a tower. And he leased it to the vintners and went into a far country. Now when vintage time drew near, he sent his servants to the vintners and that they might receive its fruit. And the vintners took his servants, beat one, killed one, and stoned another. And again he sent other servants, more than the first, and they did likewise to them. Then last of all, he sent his son to them, saying, They will respect my son. But when the vintners saw the son, they said among themselves, This is their heir. Come, let us kill him and seize his inheritance. So they took him, cast him out of the vineyard, and killed him. Therefore, when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those vintners? Have you never read the scriptures? The stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This was the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. Therefore I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken from you and given to a nation bearing the fruits of it. And whoever falls on this stone will be broken, but whomever it falls, it will grind him to powder. The kingdom of heaven is like a certain king who arranged a marriage for his son, and sent out his servants to call those who were invited to the wedding, and they were not willing to come. Again, he sent out other servants, saying, Tell those who are invited, See, I have prepared my dinner. My oxen and fattened cattle are killed, and all things are ready. Come to the wedding. But they made light of it, and went their ways, one to his own farm, another to his business, and the rest seized his servants, treated them spitefully, and killed them. But when the king heard about it, he was furious, and he sent out his armies, destroyed those murderers, and burned up their cities. Then he said to his servants, The wedding is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy. Therefore go into the highways, and as many as you find, invite to the wedding. So those servants went out into the highways and gathered together all whom they found, both bad and good, and the wedding halls were filled with guests. But when the king came in to see those guests, he saw a man there who did not have on a wedding garment. So he said to him, Friend, how did you come in here without a wedding garment? And he was speechless. Then the king said to the servants, Bind him hand and foot, take him away, and cast him into outer darkness. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth, for many are called, but few are chosen. Why do you test me, you hypocrites? Show me the tax money. Whose image and inscription is this? Render therefore to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and to God the things that belong to God. You are mistaken, not knowing the scriptures nor the power of God. For the resurrection they neither marry nor given in marriage, but are like angels of God in heaven. But concerning the resurrection of the dead, have you not read what is spoken to you by God, saying, I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. God is not the God of the dead, but of the living. You shall love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, and with all of your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. What do you think about the Christ? Whose son is he? How then does David in the Spirit call him Lord, saying, The Lord said to my Lord, Sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstool. If David then calls him Lord, how is he his son? Matthew 23. The scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat. Therefore, Whatever they tell you to observe, that observe, but do not according to their works. For they say, and do not do. For they bind heavy burdens, hard to bear, and lay them on men's shoulders. But they themselves will not move them with one of their fingers. But all their works they do to be seen by men. They make their phylacteries broad and enlarge the borders of their garments. They love the best places at feasts and best seats in the synagogues, greetings in the marketplaces, and to be called by men, Rabbi, Rabbi. But you do not be called Rabbi, for one is your teacher, the Christ, and you are all brethren. Do not call anyone on earth your father, for one is your Father, he who is in heaven. And do not be called teachers, for one is your teacher, the Christ. But he who is greatest among you shall be your servant, and whoever exalts himself will be humbled, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. But woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you shut up the kingdom of heaven against men, for you neither go in yourselves, nor do you allow those who are entering to go in. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you devour widows' houses, and for a pretense make long prayers. Therefore you will receive greater condemnation. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you travel land and sea to win one proselyte, and when he is won, you make him twice as much a son of hell as yourselves. Woe to you, blind guides, who say, whoever swears by the temple, it is nothing, but whoever swears by the gold of the temple, he is obliged to perform it. Fools and blind! For which is greater, the gold or the temple that sanctifies the gold? And whoever swears by the altar, it is nothing, but whoever swears by the gift that is on it, he is obliged to perform it. Fools and blind! For which is greater, the gift or the altar that sanctifies the gift? Therefore, who swears by the altar, swears by it, and by all things on it. He who swears by the temple, swears by it, and by him who dwells in it. And he who swears by heaven, swears by the throne of God, and by him who sits on it. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you pay tithe of mint, anise, and cumin, and have neglected the weightier matters of the law, justice and mercy and faith. These you ought to have done, without leaving the others undone. Blind guides, who strain out and gnat and swallow a camel. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you cleanse the outside of the cup and dish, but inside they are full of extortion and self-indulgence. Blind Pharisee, first cleanse the inside of the cup and dish, that the outside of them may be clean also. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you are like whitewashed tombs, which indeed appear beautiful outwardly, but inside they are full of dead men's bones and all uncleanliness. Even so, you also outwardly appear righteous to men, but inside you are full of hypocrisy and lawlessness. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, because you build the tombs of the prophets and adorn the monuments of the righteous, and say, if we had lived in the days of our fathers, we would have not been partakers with them in the blood of the prophets. Therefore you are witness against yourselves that you are sons of those who murdered the prophets. Fill up, then, the measure of your father's guilt. Serpents, brood of vipers, how can you escape the condemnation of hell? Therefore indeed I send you prophets, wise men, and scribes. Some of them you will kill and crucify, and some of them you will scourge in the synagogues, and persecute from city to city, that on you may come all the righteous blood shed on the earth, from the blood of righteous Abel to the blood of Zechariah, son of Berechiah, whom you murdered between the temple and the altar. As surely I say to you, all these things will come upon this generation. O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the one who kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to her. How often I wanted to gather your children together, as a hen gathers her chickens under her wings, but you were not willing. See, your house is left to you desolate. For I say to you, you shall see me no more till you say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Matthew 24. Do you not see all these things? Assuredly I say to you, not one stone shall be left here upon another that shall be thrown down. Take heed that no one deceives you, for many will come in my name, saying, I am the Christ, and will deceive many. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not troubled, for all these things must come to pass. But the end is not yet. For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there will be famines, pestilences, and earthquakes in various places. All these things are the beginning of sorrows. Then they will deliver you up to tribulation and kill you. And you will be hated by all nations for my name's sake. And then many will be offended, will betray one another, and will hate one another. Then many false prophets will rise up and deceive many. And because lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold. But he who endures till the end shall be saved. And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in all the world as a witness to all the nations, and then the end will come. Therefore, when you see the abomination of desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet standing in the holy place, then let those who are in Judea flee to the mountains. Let him who is at the housetops not go down to anything out of his house. And let him who is in the field not go back to get his clothes. But woe to those who are pregnant and to those who are nursing babies in those days. And pray that your flight may not be in the winter or on the Sabbath, for then there will be great tribulation, such as has not been since the beginning of the world until this time, no, nor ever shall be. And unless those days were shortened, no flesh would be saved. But for the elect's sake, those days will be shortened. Then, if anyone says to you, look, here's the Christ, or there, do not believe it. For false Christs and false prophets will rise and show great signs and wonders to deceive, if possible, even the elect. See, I have told you beforehand. Therefore, if they say to you, look, he is in the desert, do not go out or look. He is in the inner rooms, do not believe it. For as the lightning comes from the east and flashes to the west, so also will the coming of the Son of Man be. For wherever the carcass is, there the eagles will be gathered together. Immediately after the tribulation of those days, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light. The stars will fall from heaven, and the power of the heavens will be shaken. Then the sign of the Son of Man will appear in heaven, and then all the tribes of the earth will mourn, and they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he will send his angels with a great sound of a trumpet, and they will gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. Now learn this parable from the fig tree. When its branch has already become tender and puts forth leaves, you know that summer is near. So you also, when you see all these things, know that it is near, at the doors. Assuredly I say to you, this generation will by no means pass away till all these things take place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will by no means pass away. But of that day and hour no one knows, not even the angels in heaven, but my Father only. But as the days of Noah were, so also will be the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in to marriage, until the day that Noah entered the ark, and did not know until the flood came and took them all away, so also will be the coming of the Son of Man be. Then Two men will be in the field, one will be taken and the other left. Two women will be grinding at the mill, one will be taken and the other left. Watch therefore, for you do not know what hour your Lord is coming. But know this, that if the master of the house had known what hour the thief would come, he would have watched and not allowed his house to be broken into. Therefore, you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. Who then is a faithful, wise servant, whom his master made ruler over his household to give them food in due season? Blessed is that servant, whom his master, when he comes, will find so doing. Assuredly, I say to you, that he will make him ruler over his goods. But if that evil servant says in his heart, "My master is delaying his coming," and begins to beat his fellow servants and to eat and drink with the drunkards, the master of the servant will come on the day when he is not looking for him, and at that hour that he is not aware of, and will cut him in two and appoint him his portion with the hypocrites. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Matthew 25. Then the kingdom of heaven shall be likened to 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. Now 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. Those who were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them, but the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. But while the bridegroom was delayed, they all slumbered and slept. And at midnight a cry was heard, "Behold, the bridegroom is coming. Go out to meet him." Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise answered, saying, "No, lest there should not be enough for us and you. But go rather to those who sell and buy for yourselves." And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went in with him to the wedding, and the door was shut. Afterward, the other virgins came also, saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he answered and said, "Assuredly, I say to you, I do not know you. Watch therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour in which the Son of Man is coming back. For the kingdom of heaven is like a man traveling to a far country, who called his servants and delivered his goods to them. And to one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to another 1, to each according to his own ability. And immediately he went on a journey. Then he who received the 5 talents went and traded with them, and made another 5 talents. And likewise, he who had received 2 gained 2 more also. But he who had received 1 went and dug into the ground and hid his Lord's money. After a long time, the Lord of the servants came and settled accounts with them. So he who had received 5 talents came and brought 5 other talents, saying, 'Lord, you delivered to me 5 talents. Look, I have gained 5 more talents besides them.' His Lord said to him, 'Well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord.' He also who had received 2 talents came and said, 'Lord, you delivered me 2 talents. Look, I have gained 2 more talents besides them.' His Lord said to him, 'Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a few things. I will now make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord.' Then he who had received the 1 talent came and said, 'Lord, I knew you've been a hard man, reaping where you have not sown, and gathering where you have not scattered seed. And I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Look, there you have what is yours.' But his Lord answered and said to him, 'You wicked and lazy servant, you knew that I reap where I have not sown, and gather where I have not scattered seed. So you ought to have deposited my money with the bankers, and at my coming I would have received back my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to him who has 10 talents. For to everyone who has, more will be given, and he will have abundance. But from him who does not have, even what he has will be taken away. And cast the unprofitable servant into the outer darkness. There will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd divides his sheep from the goats. And he will set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right hand, "Come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger, and you took me in. I was naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came to me." Then the righteous will answer him, saying, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and take you in, or naked and clothed you? Or when did we see you sick or in prison and come to you?" And the king will answer and say to them, "Assuredly I say to you, inasmuch as you did it to the one of the least of these my brethren, you did it to me." Then he will also say to those on the left hand, "Depart from me, you cursed, into the everlasting fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. I was a stranger, and you did not take me in. Naked, and you did not clothe me. Sick and in prison, and you did not visit me." Then they will also answer him, saying, "Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or sick or in prison, and did not minister to you?" Then he will answer them, saying, "Assuredly I say to you, inasmuch as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me." And these will go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into eternal life. Matthew 26 through 28. You know that after 2 days is the Passover, and the Son of Man will be delivered up to be crucified. Why do you trouble the woman? For she has done good work for me. For you have the poor with you always, but me you do not always have. For in pouring this fragrant oil on my body, she did it for my burial. Assuredly I say to you, wherever this gospel is preached in the whole world, what this woman has done will also be told as a memorial to her. Go into the city to a certain man and say to him, 'The teacher says, my time is at hand. I will keep the Passover at your house with my disciples. Assuredly I say to you, one of you will betray me. He who dipped his hand with me in the dish will betray me. The Son of Man indeed goes, just as it is written for him. But woe to the man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It will have been good for that man if he had not been born." You have said it. Take, eat. This is my body. Drink from it, all of you. For this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. But I say to you, I will not drink of this fruit of the vine from now on until the day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. All of you will be made to stumble because of me this night, for it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered. But after I have been raised, I will go before you to Galilee. Assuredly I say to you, that this night, before the rooster crows, you will deny me 3 times. Sit here while I go and pray over there. My soul is exceedingly sorrowful, even to death. Stay here and watch with me. Oh, my Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I, but as you will. What? Could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray, lest you enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. Oh, my Father, if this cup cannot pass away from me unless I drink it, your will be done. Are you still sleeping and resting? Behold, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is being betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand. Friend, why have you come? Put your sword into its place, for all who take the sword will perish by the sword. Or do you think that I cannot now pray to my Father, and he will provide me with more than 12 legions of angels? How then could the scriptures be fulfilled, that it must happen thus? Have you come out as against a robber, with swords and clubs to take me? I sat daily with you, teaching in the temple, and you did not seize me. But all this was done, that the scriptures of the prophets might be fulfilled. It is as you said. Nevertheless, I say to you, hereafter, you will see the Son of Man sitting at the right hand of the power and coming on the clouds of heaven. Before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times. It is as you say.
Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? My God, why have you forsaken me?
Rejoice, do not be afraid. Go and tell my brethren to go to Galilee, and there they will see me. All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Amen.